Assalamu alaikum and welcome to Jan Sewing Solutions. Now it's been a while since we've not actually made anything for my gorgeous little princess Innaya, and since Eid is approaching I want to design something for her. I feel a bit of a miser here because I'm going to be using a very very oldest gold suit. This is going back to when I first opened my Dilpasand shop and I actually bought this fabric in, and we did a fashion show and I designed this outfit, and then it got worn by the models and then it's just been lying there. And whilst we were tidying up, I came across this. Now most of it I put in charity bags, but I didn't feel like putting this in the charity bag because one, I felt that it was a shame to give something away. I didn't think it had sort of very much of life left in it because of the length of time. The fabric is tissue organza and it doesn't really have that much of a long life, but the work on it is absolutely beautiful. The color, the goldy color, is absolutely beautiful. So what we're gonna do is make a quick outfit out of this, and even if Innaya can wear it for the day on Eid, then I'm perfectly happy with that. So the way we're going to make this is this is an already made dress. So first of all, what I need to do is to sort of take this apart one from the other, and basically what the way this has been stitched is it's been stitched two separate, like the front and the top, and it's not been sewn together. So this is the lining, and we can actually pull the top of it away. Now it's quite long, so I'm going to make this into a dress and also like a jacket over it. So this is going to be the lining for the bottom dress. So basically we've just taken that away, and then I'm going to reshape this. It's just going to be a normal ordinary dress. So we just want the armhole. And I'll shape it as we're going along as and when required. For the moment, just the basic structure of the dress. Now some of the work is already going to be done in this because of the fact that it's already stitched, so it's going to save us valuable time. So that's the lining. Now what we can do is if we get one piece of our lining, we put that on top of this, use the lining as the template, and just basically cut around the top layer in the similar shape as our and that way you've separated the two. Now at this point, what I would suggest is to actually give this a nice press and then center it, half it like this, and place the lining, press that as well, press them both and place them on top of each other, and then fine tune into your size, so that way it's all neatly finished. So this is the bottom layer. Now I'm going, not going to put sleeves or anything on this. This is just going to be just a normal sort of like a little bit like an A-line dress, because it's going to have a jacket on going on top of this. Now what this does seem like, that is just a little bit too long. So what I might do is just chop. Also the back of this is slightly longer as well. So when I've pressed this and when I come to reshaping it, I'll measure it for size, and then if I need to, I'll slightly take off from the top just to put it into shape. So okay, that we'll put to a side. Now the next part that we're going to come to, now this, the suit that was sewn, this was a trouser, and that's the shape of the trouser. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to be making a jacket out of this. I've opened all the leg parts off the trouser. What to do is just half the leg size, because this is going to be sort of galidar type of a jacket, and it's going to have 4 pieces in the galidar. Okay, these are the 4 for the front and 4 for the back, because I've done the exact same with all the 4 pieces of the 8 pieces of the trouser. So out of this, first of all, there's a bit of a damage on here, so we'll just chop that away. It means slightly shortening, but, and we're going to take away, make it into like a now these pieces are going to be the back pieces. Going to come together is they're going to be stitched like this. They're going to be stitched like this. It's going to have a nice heavy border and a velvet piece at the top. Now this is these are the back 4 panels. And we're also going to cut the 4 front panels. Now, with the front panels, we're going to take the 1 piece away. Now these 2 pieces we're just going to cut same as our back ones. Now there's no set rule on how big you want these pieces. Depending on the waist size, what you want as the waist or the chest size, and it's just basically a straight cut, and you can have it as wide or slightly narrow at the bottom according to your fabric. Now this obviously is the fabric that I have, so I'm going to be using whatever fabric I have to actually make this. Now these are the 2 side pieces. For my center fronts, the one side of this I want straight because I'm going to be using, and then the other side I want it shaped. Now the side that's straight is going to be the open, and on that, so basically what we're going to have is that. And on the side that's open, I'm going to be adding, this is the edge of the, originally this was a dupatta and this was the edge that was left, so I'm going to be using that on to finish the front of the jacket, just to jazz it up. Basically that's going to go on the front opening, and this jacket is going to be the overcoat on top of the dress. Now for the that's going to go on at the top, so that's our bodice, and then we've got that going on there, and that piece attaching to that, and then we've got that piece attaching in the center here. And then we've got this piece going on here. And we've got this going on the either side of the jacket. Like that. And then what we have is that lace we're going to have as a trim going all the way around the bottom of the hem. We're going to take this little bit, these little teeny weeny bits of sleeves, and we're going to recoat them. Sleeves here, like such, and just a final a back of this to cut out, and that's basically it. That, so let's get the layout of this. So basically what you've got is, you put the pieces out so you get an idea of what you will be left with, is we've got that and we've got that on top of it. Then we've got that going on top of that. Sleeves going down there, And that basically is a gorgeous dress that hasn't cost us a penny and is going to take perhaps an hour to make, and she's going to have something that nobody else will have. It'll be exceptional, and you know what, children are not gonna yesterday I was at the bazaar and I saw mums looking around frantically to buy the stuff for their children, and yet this is one of the best ways of designing and sewing for your children, because children are not going to fuss. As long as if you make something for them, they will love you irrespective of what the fabric was or how you went about making it. It is ultimately the making that's the home design making. So anyway, that's going to be the baby dress. I hope to see you, and I hope to show you this, baby innaya. My words are all mixed up. It's too early in the morning. I didn't go back to sleep after Fajr, and I've dedicated this morning to try and finish off some of the clothes that I'm making. So my mind is all over the place. Do forgive me if I say something that's out of place, because it is very early in the morning. So I shall hopefully show you the result of this on Eid day, when my pretty princess will actually wear and show the outcome of this beautiful dress. Now what I'm going to say here is, as long as you've made the structure right and you've sort of put a little bit of effort or emphasis on that, then you should have absolutely no problem in getting the end result. Now there is something else that I was just thinking of perhaps doing. Was perhaps taking the hem border off and attaching it here. Or shall I just... No, I'll leave it there. Children tend to like having the upper portion. Comfortable. So I shall leave that. I'm going to do something better. I'm going to cut this out and I'm going to stick it on the velvet, and that will actually give it a little bit of an emphasis on the bodice as well. Okay, so how are we going to do this? Well, we're just going to cut around the velvet, and then we're going to put this on, iron some wonder web onto this, and just iron this onto the velvet bodice. Yeah.